name is Amparo Abel-Bey. I work at Columbia University Medical Center in the Neurological Institute in the Division of Stroke. I've always wanted to have a profound effect on groups of individuals, right? So how do you touch them? How do you get to as many people as possible? And I think social research is a special way that I could make the most out of my time and see the most number of people and then teach them about how to be advocates for themselves, how to motivate themselves, empower themselves in order to obtain better health. I was born in Flushing, Queens and raised in Long Island. I started my undergrad at City College in New York, finished at Stony Brook University, and obtained my master's at Columbia University. Yes, I would consider myself definitely a science nerd. I always want to know what makes people tick. So my mother's an elementary school teacher and my father's an obstetrician gynecologist. And so the marriage between educating and healthcare was pretty much how I was raised. Actually, my father had a stroke and you know, today he's very much rehabilitated. Most people wouldn't know, but that definitely had a profound effect on my worldview. Stroke doesn't just affect that one person who actually has that incident, you know? It's about everyone around them. I'm creating a relationship. That's one of the first things that I'm doing. I take people's blood pressure, you know, I ask them if they're managing their blood pressure or not, so on and so forth. And with the TOSH project, the stroke education project that I'm working on, we follow up with individuals who fit our criteria for the study. And from there, I'm seeing them again at 6 month and 1 year intervals. And so I've you know, deepened that relationship that I have with everyone. And I think that that's extremely meaningful. Overall, our mission is to spread knowledge, honestly. You know, and to empower people to live in a way that they are happy and healthy, you know, improving quality of life. I think that's the overall mission, for everyone to be their own advocate. I can't imagine myself doing anything differently right now. This is, yeah, I love my career. I love my job. I love knowing that every day is going to be a little different. It's a lot of hard work, it's a lot of long hours, it's a lot of different hours, right? Because when you're working with the community, you have to be where they're at when they're out, right? So we could be doing health fairs on the weekends, we could be doing interviews on weeknights, we could, you know, I could pull a 12-hour day or so on and so forth, you know? But, oh my goodness, it's so worth it. I'm extremely proud to be in this kind of field. This is... I love that I have the opportunity to not only, you know, work with data, but also be with people. I think that's my strong suit, and I think any people person would like that, you know, be on the ground and be that face of public health, and that's, I love that.